Welcome to RSSBI 2018 Ahmedabad. I am Dr. Shao Ingole and you are watching me live on therightdoctors.com. I am glad to have with me the eminent personality, the famous endocrinologist from New Delhi, Dr. B.M. Makkar sir. So welcome to the show sir.
Thank you.
So sir, based on your recent talk in RSSBI 2018, which was on remission of type 2 diabetes mellitus, we all know that the burden of diabetes mellitus is increasing dramatically globally as well as in India. So we would like to know your views on the remission of type 2 diabetes mellitus and its future.
Thank you. Type 2 diabetes, we know, is a major healthcare challenge in India. All over the world, it is a big challenge, but in India, you know, it is rising in prevalence at a very rapid pace. And the unfortunate part is, it is affecting Indians at a younger age, almost 10 to 15 years earlier as compared to the white population. And with increasing body weight, the prevalence is increasing at a pace which is not predictable also. In past, whatever predictions for prevalence of diabetes have happened, all have failed and the numbers have surpassed those predictions much earlier than we were predicting them. And that is because we are also having, increasing prevalence of obesity, which is one of the major drivers for increasing prevalence of type 2 diabetes. Now, interesting thing is that till date, we have been considering type 2 diabetes as a disease which is, once it is occurring, once it happens, there is no cure for it and you can only control it and treat it for lifelong. Till recently, this was the situation and it's largely this is the situation even now. But from bariatric surgery, we started understanding that if we induce significant weight loss, we can put these patients in remission. And taking cue from this, you know, bariatric surgery data, recently, there was a study published, presented at International Diabetes Federation meeting and also published, which showed that if we create a similar dietary restriction as happens after bariatric surgery, possibly we are able to induce remission in type 2 diabetes patients. So this was a study done by Dr. Roy Taylor from US, UK. And the study was done in 45 primary care practices, which is interesting because, you know, it was not the specialist healthcare practices that were being looked at. So it was primary care practices, 45 health practices across England and Scotland. And these patients were treated with acute restriction of caloric intake and lifestyle modifications. And all these patients were put on 800 calories diet for a period of 3 to 5 months. With a target weight loss of 15% body weight. And after that, there was stepwise reintroduction of the normal meals, but it was not the high calorie meals, it was the normal food. And once they analyzed the data, almost 50% of these patients went into remission of diabetes. And when they looked at the different segments of data, people who lost more than 15% body weight, there was almost 85% remission of diabetes. People who lost more than 10% body weight, 55% went into remission of diabetes. So what does this show? It shows that if we put these patients or if we treat these patients with acute caloric restriction, we are somehow changing the traffic of fatty acids into liver and pancreas, and possibly we are decongesting the fat or ectopic fat that is already present in these organs, leading to normalization of insulin resistance at the level of liver and normalization of beta cell in pancreas, leading to a normal insulin secretion and normal glucose production from liver. This helps in normalizing the blood glucose. Now, shall we call this a complete reversal? I don't know, because genetic predisposition also plays a very important role. But definitely, if we can put these patients in remission, then we are changing the whole trajectory of diabetes. One, by giving good early correction of the glycemia, hyperglycemia, and giving them a good glycemic memory, we will cut down the risk of complications. We will have a good metabolic memory for these patients, so they'll be less prone to get complications and less risk of mortality in long run. Second thing is, if these people do not gain weight, and they are able to keep their diabetes off for a few years, the whole risk of complication is deferred by a few decades, which will give them a very good quality of life, cut down the cost of therapy, cut down the cost of management, and cut down the disease burden overall. It is a very interesting concept which is coming up, and I think we should look at this option for all our diabetes patients who are overweight or obese and come within 4 to 5 years of onset of diabetes.
So, sir, as you rightly said, the weight reduction with the help of bariatric surgery can induce the remission in type 2 diabetes mellitus patients. So, we would like to know, do you want to recommend the bariatric surgery surgery in all types of patients, or you want to suggest this recommendation to specific group of patients?
So, bariatric surgery is one of the options for weight loss. Now, if you look at the indications for bariatric surgery, one of the most important criteria is that people who fail on medical management of obesity. Unfortunately, we have never been able to manage very well with the medical management, and because the implementation of medical management involves a teamwork, which involves a dietitian, a physician, a behavior therapist, training in regular exercise, and patient motivation. Bariatric surgery kind of offers a shortcut, but you have to keep in mind that people have to follow the lifestyle changes even after bariatric surgery. If they are not following lifestyle changes, there is a tendency for regain of weight even after bariatric surgery, and the whole metabolic benefit they are achieving will be lost once they regain weight. In my own setting, we are seeing patients who are coming to us with weight regain after bariatric surgery also, and then they have to go for medical management only. So I think we need to be more aggressive with medical management, because in that case, we are not changing the normal anatomy. We are not doing any intervention in terms of invasive procedure. We are trying to create a healthy lifestyle, healthy eating habit, and a regular exercise pattern, which in any case is not going to benefit only in the remission of diabetes. It is going to cut down the risk of dyslipidemia, hypertension, coronary artery disease, everything. And if it does not work, bariatric surgery still is an option. But I think if we can achieve this without a surgical intervention, it is going to be phenomenal.
Sir, as you rightly said that bariatric surgery can induce the remission, but nobody is sure, or the data is not conclusive, whether it can lead to the complete remission of the disease or not. So considering that, do you foresee that there be on and off phenomenon if someone goes for the bariatric surgery?
Patients come back with weight gain?
Yeah.
So if the patient gains back weight, the whole metabolic story changes, it reverses. So people who are losing weight today are getting into remission of diabetes, it is very likely when they gain back weight, their blood pressures will go up, their sugars will go up, their lipids will change, everything is likely to get disturbed.
So considering that there can be the remission of the disease with the lifestyle intervention, do you foresee that this will definitely help the patients who are on anti-diabetic therapy for a prolonged period, where compliance is the major issue?
I think it is a very interesting concept, and it is very much feasible. And in my own practice, we have now a number of patients whom we have put on acute caloric restriction in combination with regular exercise, and we have a decent number of patients who have already gone into remission. There we have patients who were on multiple drugs for diabetes, hypertension, and dyslipidemia, and they are totally off drugs. We have patients who were on insulin and oral agents combined, and they are also off drugs. Look at the study, which is the direct trial, which data I mentioned about Roy Taylor. In this study, they in fact recruited diabetes patients. They stopped their drugs totally, and they put them on 800 calories diet from day one. And within a week's time, the sugar levels had come down to normal after stopping drug also. So there is no reason why it is not doable. Only thing is, it requires patient motivation, It requires teamwork on the side of medical management. You need to have a physician who knows this concept, who understands this concept. You need to have a nutritionist who can manage the patient on 800 calorie diet and monitor the issues related to VLCDs, and you have to have behavior therapist who can give a moral support or take care of the psychological aspects of management, and somebody who guides for the exercise. So it's a team management, but it works. And in my practice, we have seen results.
So thank you so much, sir, for such a wonderful interaction and throwing the light on somewhat the newer kind of a concept, the remission of the diabetes mellitus. Thank you so much.